Good afternoon, my name is Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to today's daily market update. Today we're going to start with the key economic data we've had out so far, and that comes from the UK. Now we saw the public sector net borrowing came out showing a deficit of £1.8 billion. Now this is a lower figure than we were expecting. It does show that the government is continuing to struggle to meet these deficit targets which it has set itself, and it could actually lead to further austerity later this year in order to meet these targets. However, this doesn't seem to have spooked people too much. If we look at the cable charts, we can actually see sterling has extended its gains today. It's broke above that 157 area yesterday and actually ended the session above here. Since then it's actually made its way higher, targeting the top of that ascending triangle around 157.70, and it's actually broken above here straight away, and however it has started to fall back slightly since breaking above here. If it does manage to end the day above this level though, we could actually see the sterling extend its gains, maybe even reaching 160 over the next couple of weeks. However, given the fact that we're already starting to see it fall back and we don't actually see too much sterling strength over the next couple of weeks, fundamentally, I do expect actually we'll see it fall back and actually end the session below this 157.70 area, maybe even potentially make its way towards the bottom of this ascending triangle. However, you can see though in this triangle, we are approaching the end of it, so we do expect to see a breakout pretty shortly. Elsewhere, we have had a Spanish auction earlier on today. Now this was an auction for 12 and 18 month notes. The yields came out on these at 3.07 and 3.335% respectively. These are much lower yields than we did see at the previous auction of the same notes, which does really show how much sentiment has changed over the last couple of weeks in the euro area. Now we have had comments a few weeks ago from Mario Draghi saying the ECB will do anything it can to preserve the euro, which led to suggestions we may actually see the resumption of the securities markets program. Last week, over the weekend, we actually saw stories that the ECB may be putting a cap on certain eurozone bonds in order to stop them reaching unsustainable levels, such as especially in Spain and Italy, where they've been sitting around that 6-7% area for a number of months now, and we have seen Mario Draghi again say that these are unreasonable levels, that they don't necessarily reflect what is going on in the country at the moment. So these were stories again of bond buying when they reach these levels, similar to what we saw with the Swiss National Bank with the Euro Swiss cap, which was implemented. When we saw it fall below this level, we did see the Swiss National Bank intervene in the markets, buying the euro and selling the Swiss franc in order to move this price higher, taking the strain off the euro. So we're looking to see something similar from the ECB if the yields on these bonds actually, if the spread on these yields above these German 10-year bonds, if it reaches levels, which we haven't actually heard what these levels are at the moment. But this is another bond buying program which we are looking at and which has been hinted at over the weekend. However, we have had the Bundesbank and the ECB both come out since this, denying these reports. However, with all these stories now coming out of bond buying programs from the ECB, it is looking likely that we are going to see something emerge, probably towards the middle of September, once we've had some more details, especially earlier in the month from the ECB press conference, as well as towards the middle of the month with results in the German Constitutional Court. We are expecting to hear some form of plan in the eurozone in order to bring these yields lower. It's been a number of months now, and it can only go on for so long before these countries do have to request some kind of aid or some form of bailout. We have seen though in the euro dollar charts, we have seen the euro trading higher, and again this is just a result of this increased optimism that we are going to see further action. We've seen the euro actually break above 123.60, where it has found resistance over the last few days. It's actually broken above 124 and is even making its way towards 125. At the moment it's found resistance around that 124.70 level. However, if we do actually see it stay above this 123.60 level, I do expect we'll see it target 126, 127 over the next couple of weeks. Looking ahead till tomorrow, we've actually got the FOMC meetings out the US from the Fed meeting earlier this month. We are going to be looking for clues that the Fed are considering a further QE in the US. However, there is low expectations in results in respect to this, with the fact that we've had some positive data out over the last couple of weeks from the US, and we've also seen a lot of resistance to this from the Fed over the last 3 or 4 months when the data has been struggling, especially if you compare it to what we saw in Q1, especially with jobs figures, manufacturing figures, with exports really struggling as a result of this Eurozone crisis really taking hold of the US economy. So like I say, there is low expectation, but they are going to be watched closely for hints that we may see it over the next few months. For now though, that's all we've got time for. My name's Craig Earl, I'm market analyst at Alpari UK. Thank you very much for joining us.